Hello, welcome back to VTV Shikshana program. So this is my lecture 4 on the flip-flop and its application. In the last class, we had completed, I think, master-slave JK SR flip-flop. Today, we will take up the master-slave JK flip-flop, okay? And we even saw in the previous class, the master-slave SR flip-flop is a pulse trigger, okay? And we could make sure that my output of the master slave SR is not sensitive to the level of the enable input. Okay, so and we came to know that there is a concept called ones and zeros, and we'll try to see whether the same thing persists in master slave JK flip flop or not. Okay, in the master slave JK flip flop, again similar to the master slave SR flip flop, we will take two SR latch. Okay, one SR latch acting as a master and another SR latch acting as a slave. Okay. And again, same thing holds good when master is enabled, slave is disabled. Vice versa, when slave is enabled, master is disabled, depending upon the clock input. Okay. When clock, that is C, is 1 means master enabled, slave disabled. When C 0, master disabled, slave enabled. Okay. So one difference if you find between the master slave JK flip-flop and the master slave SR flip-flop is you'll have at the input side two AND gates. AND gate 1 and AND gate 2. Okay, for the AND gate 1, one of the input is J and another input is the complement output of the master slave JK. Okay, and for the AND gate 2, one of the input is K and another input is the uncomplement output over here. So that means the second input of AND gate 2 is Q, and one of the input of the AND gate 1 is Q bar. Okay, so this is what we mean by, this is my Q bar. Okay, this is what we'll try to have. Now, we'll try to analyze this master slave JK flip-flop. Okay, so now again, since we want the feedback acting as an input, I'll let this Q is equal to 0. You can see that whatever the slave output is there, QS, that itself is my Q. Okay? And QS bar is Q bar. And whatever the output the master is having, that is QM, is nothing but what acts as a S input for the slave. And QM bar acts as an R input for the slave. Yes? So in other words, I can say that the QM acts as an input and QM bar also acts as an input to the slave flip-flop. QM is nothing but S and QM bar is nothing but R now. Okay. And since this is an SR latch and when this is enabled, this is disabled, right? When this is disabled, output doesn't change. Okay. And when I say QS is 0, QS bar is 1 means output is reset, right? Output is reset. In other words, I can say that this will reset, ensuring S is 0 and R is 1. In other words, QM is 0 and QM bar is 1. Okay, this is what we'll try to see now. Now, assuming my previous Q and Q bar is 1, 0, we'll try to see. So here I get 1 and here I get 0. Okay, this is fed back. Now, I let J is equal to 1, K is equal to 0. That means in the truth table, if I see, I'll consider the one of the input combination J is 1 and K is 0. Okay, this is what I'm doing. And until unless I apply the clock, this won't be triggered, right? So now I'll try to apply the clock is equal to 1 now. Yes, so here what I'll try to do is I'll try to draw the clock inputs. Okay, so we'll try to analyze both in the form of truth table as well as in the form of waveform. Is this clear? This is what we'll try to do now. So you can see that the clock, that is C, alternately will go from 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. This is what, right? So you can say, ensure that my x-axis is with respect to the time. Okay, x-axis with respect to time, and my y-axis, okay, whatever the y-axis I am having here, okay, I'll just write it here, my y-axis will be with respect to magnitude. Yes, okay, in general, I'll just make sure it is magnitude. Okay, this is my C input or the clock. Yes, this is what. So initially clock was zero, this is disabled. Okay, I'll have two outputs. One is QM, output of the master, and then Q, which is nothing but what the QS. Okay, Q is nothing but what the slave output. Okay, so initially QM is zero as well as Q is zero. Okay, because QM 0, QM bar 1, that means S 0, R 1, so it will be reset and output bar will be set. Okay, so this is what I am having. Okay, so this is what really happening. So this is my C clock, okay, going alternate 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. I will try to analyze what is my QM. So initially QM is 0, that's why my Q is also 0. Now, clock is 1, okay. J is 1, Q bar is 1, output of AND gate 1 is 1, and Q is 0, J is 0, output of AND gate 2 is 0. Yes, this is what is happening now. So S1 R0, and we know that when clock is 1, we can say master is enabled. When clock is 0, slave is enabled. So similarly, it goes something like this. Okay, so clock 0 slave enabled, clock 1 master enabled, clock 0 slave enabled, clock 1 master enabled. Okay, if in this particular clock 1 slave is not there, means it is disabled, that's the meaning. Okay, so clock is 1, master is enabled, so this is disabled, means Q doesn't change when clock is 1, but QM will change because master is enabled. So master is enabled now because clock is 1, S is 1 and R is 0. We know that SR latch, S1 R0 output will set. So QM will go 1, okay, and it will retain 1 since we are not changing my JK, okay, until master is enabled. That is when C is equal to 0. Yes. Now, when slave is enabled in the next half pulse, that is C is equal to 0, master is disabled. Master disabled means it will hold its previous. This will be the next output, means this will be the previous. So it will not change until the next clock comes. This is what really happens with QM. Okay, this is what. So when master was enabled, when C was 1, my Q doesn't change. It will be holding its previous value. Okay. Now you can see when S is equal to 0, sorry, that is when C is equal to 0, slave is enabled. Okay. When slave is enabled, QM was 1, QM bar was 0. So what is the slave inputs now? S is 1, R is 0 means output will set. So from 0, it becomes, okay, 1. And from 1, it becomes 0. Okay, this is what I am having. This is 0. This was 1, this was 0. So now my Q will change to 1 at this particular point. Yes. And it will retain 1 till the next time the slave is enabled. Yes. Now, next, master is trying to be enabled when clock is 0. Now, what I'll try to do is, I'll change my J0 and K1. And now the latest value of Q is 1. So, this becomes 1 and this is 0. Okay, I'll just make it, this is 0. So, instead of this 1, now Q bar is 0. Yes. So for the next time when the master is enabled, I am changing my J to 0, K1. And we know that Q bar is 0 and Q is 1. So the AND gate 1 results in 0 output. And AND gate 2, 1 and 1 results in 1 output. This is what I am adding. So now you can see that S0, R1 of master means QM from 1, it becomes 0, that is reset. Q bar is set. S0, R1 output is reset. And this doesn't change now. So QM now becomes 0 when master is enabled, and it will retain the same thing until the next time it becomes enabled. Yes. Now, after the master enabled, when clock becomes 0 for the second time, slave is enabled. And when slave is enabled, we know that QM is 0 and QM bar is 1. My output will from 0 it had become 1. Okay. Previously. Now, 0 again it is becoming. So, this was 0. So, it is becoming 1. And this is becoming 0. The only reason is S0 R1 output is reset. So, you can see that my slave output goes to 0 and it will retain 0 until the next time slave becomes 1. Clear? Now, for the next time when clock is 1, okay, I am just changing my JK. So, we saw that now J0 K1 output was reset. This is what. Next, we'll come to the third input combination of JK, both 0, 0. And now, Q is 0. Yes, Q bar is 1. Okay, we'll see. 1, 0, this is 0. 0, 0, this is also 0. So, both S and R 0, 0. When both S and R 0, 0, what is the meaning? Out SR latch will follow the previous. What is previous here? If this is the next output, previous is 0. So, it will retain 0. So, this will still be 0 and this will be still be 0 and this will be still be 1. That is QM bar. Okay. And this will retain this 0 until the next time the master becomes 1. Now, when S is equal to 0, this is enabled, this is disabled. QM is 0 again. QM bar is 1. So, again this will be in the previous case until the next time it becomes 1. Next, what I'll do, so when 0, 0, there is no change, that is previous. Now, the last possible combination I'll come, that is 1, 1. So, when both J as well as K are 1 and 1. Okay. Q is still 0, that's why it is still 0. Q bar is still 1, that's why it is still 1. Okay. Now, master is enabled because third time the clock, fourth time the clock is becoming 1. 1, 1, this is 1. Okay. 1, 0, this is still 0. So, when S1 R 0, QM will be 1. So, previously it was 0, it will be 1. And this will be 0. Yes. So, QM becomes 1 and it will retain 1 till the next clock pulse. Yes. And now when slave is enabled, when clock is becoming 0, you can see that S is nothing but 1, R is nothing but 0. So, this will change from 0 to 1 and this will change from 1 to 0. That is S1 R0 output will set. And this is what really happening. And it will retain until the next time 1 comes. So, now what we'll try to see. Okay, we'll try to go now. We'll take one more cycle, 0 and 1. Now Q is 1, Q bar is 0, right? And now I am not changing my J and K. For the next clock pulse also, J and K will retain the same now. We'll see what really happens to the output now, okay? So, for the fifth time when clock is becoming 1, master is enabled and J is 1, 1. So, output side of 1 AND gate 1 is 0 now because 1 0. Here it is 1 1, it becomes 0. Sorry, this is 1 1 means it becomes 1. Sorry. So S 0, R 1, this will be 0 and this will be 1 now. So this goes from 1 to 0 and it will retain 1. And in the next, when clock is 0, that is when slave is enabled, the same thing. S is 0, R is 1 means this will go 1, 0 and it will retain for the next time. Okay. That means what is happening? When JK 1, 1, you can see that 1 is becoming 0 and 0 is becoming 1. That means it is simply ensuring that it is a complement bar. If output is previous output is 0 means it becomes 1. If previous output is 1 means 0 means it becomes 1. Okay, this is what really happens now. So in the first case, in the first clock cycle, this is what I mean by the clock cycle. We had taken this condition J1 K0, you can see that output is set. In the second clock pulse, okay, we had considered J to be 0, K to be 1, output is reset. Okay, this is 0, this is 1, this is reset. In the third clock pulse, okay, we had taken J and K to be 0, 0. We know that output will follow the previous. For this cycle, you can see that 0 was the previous and it will continue to be 0. And for the fourth clock pulse, we had considered J and K to be 1, 1. Okay. When J1, K1, you can see that this is the next output. It is the complement of the previous. Previous was 0, now it becomes 1. And for the fifth clock pulse cycle, again we had let J and K to be 1, 1 only. And again it is going complement of the previous. Previous was 1, now it is becoming 0. Okay. This is what my truth table, whether it is a master slave or whether it is a gated JK flip-flop, my truth table still remains the same, but we have overcome here the race around condition. You can see that in when master is enabled, even though I change JK, my Q doesn't change because slave is disabled. Is this clear now? QM might vary, but that doesn't affect my slave when this is changing. Okay, that's why we have overcome the race around condition. But again here, we can see that zeros and ones catching here. Okay, zeros and ones catching here in master slave. And we can see that if my J and K are 1, 1 for consecutive clock pulse, so I get 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, something like this continue. And this particular situation, okay, wherein for the consecutive clock pulses, if I let J and K to be 1, my Q, that is the output of the master slave, will go alternately 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And this particular 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 combination, what we are taking, we call this particular thing as something like toggling. Okay. And this toggling is very important for us when we deal the one of the application of the flip-flop, that is the counters, okay, ripple counter or the asynchronous counter. Okay, so this is all about your master slave. This overcomes the level sensitive, that means we won't be getting the race around condition, but we will getting something called the toggling effect, that is for whenever the J and K are continuously one for the successful clock periods, means output will have a sequence of 1010100 or 0101010101, which we call it as a toggling. And one more effect we see in the master slave JK or SR flip-flop is ones and zeros catching. This is all about the master slave JK flip-flop, which overcomes the level sensitive, and now it is a pulse sensitive. You can see that my output will change, okay, after a small pulse is overcome here. Okay, this is what. Next, the timing diagram. I just saw, I drew and saw that, but now we'll try to see now. So initially, clock was 0, irrespective of what is my J and K. Okay, I let QM to be 0, and that the same thing will be appearing at this also. And when QM is 0, QM bar is 1, and when QA or QS is 0, Q bar or QS bar is 1. This is what I'm having. Okay, next. And I'm interested in checking the output QM and Q only when clock becomes 1 and then 0. Okay. So this will be my first clock pulse. This will be my first clock cycle. Okay. With the positive pulse and the negative pulse. Okay. Something like this. That is 1 and 0. 1. 0, 1, 0, 1 and 0. This is 0. Okay. So, when C is 1, we know that master is enabled. When C is 0, slave. This is master. This is slave. This is master. This is slave enabled. This is master enabled, and this is my slave enabled. Okay. So when master enabled, what is my J? J is 1, K is 0. I can simply say QM is 1 and QM bar will be 0. That is, it will be set. Clear? And the moment the clock is 0 means master is disabled. Okay. At this point, master is disabled. But I know that when the flip-flop is disabled, it will follow the previous, that is, it is 1 only until my next clock comes. Clear? And when the master is disabled, slave is enabled. And when slave is enabled, QM itself is acting as an input to the slave. So QM is nothing but what? S for the S input for the slave. And QM bar is nothing but R input. So when S is 1, R is 0, I can say that this is 1 and this is 0. And we can see that the same ones and zeros catching. And now, first I'll complete the QM and then we'll try to see the master's output. Sorry, slave output. When M is 1 for the second time, okay. So J is 0, K is 0 for some duration of time. So that's why it will follow the previous. And J 0, K 1. When J is 0, K 1 means what? It will reset. That's why it has reset. S. And then it is 0, 0 within. Clock is 1. 0, 0 means previous. So that's why it is continuing previous only. And then it will retain previous until the next time this becomes 1. Yes. And when M becoming, that is when C is 1, that is master enabled, you can see that J0, K1 at this point, it is still the reset. And when 1 and 1, output will be the previous. Okay. This is the 1 means previous was 0, that's why it is becoming 1. This was 0, that's why it is becoming 1 here. And you can see that 1, for some time it returns 1. And when slave is enabled, master is disabled means it will see the previous. And when master is enabled because C is 1, again my J and K are 1 once, so output will be the complements of previous. So if previous is 1, output is 0 and it will come. Okay. This is what. And we can see that the same thing will be repeating with respect to Q. Okay. When M is enabled, whatever the master output is there, the slave output will follow. You can see that when master is enabled, okay, this is 1 and this is 0, and this is 1 and this is 1. This is 1 means this is 1 and then it will be 0. Okay. The same explanation what I gave in the previous case, it is the same thing. And you can see here again, when clock is, when JK11 for more than 2 cycles, you can see I'll have 0 to 1 transition and 1 to 0 transition. This is, and here also 0, 1 and 0. And if the same thing continues, it will be 1. This is what we mean by the toggling condition. Okay, so this is what is all about my JK flip-flop, that is master slave JK flip-flop, which is a pulse triggered rather than a level sensitive. And we overcome the race around condition. Okay, but we have something called the ones and zeros catching. Okay, we have ones and zeros catching. And this is evident. This is evident from this. Whatever the master is there, after the half pulse, my slave is getting. So slave is catching my master. If it is 1, it will catch 1. If it is 0, it will catch 0. This is what we mean. Okay, this is what about timing diagram of master slave. Then master slave D flip flop. So we know that how to get a D flip flop on a from a SR. If I short SR, S and R through my inverter, this becomes a D flip flop or a delay. So when C is equal to 1, if D is 0, I get Q to be 0. Okay, so for 1 clock cycle. Okay. Again, here it's a master slave means I have both master as well as a slave. So when C is 1, master is enabled. When C is equal to 0, slave is enabled. At this point, my Q will change. And I can say that when D is equal to 0, Q is equal to 1. So for the next clock pulse 1 and 0, in the clock cycle of this, if my input D is changing from 0 to 1, output also will catch the same thing. And this is, these are the symbols of this now. Okay. So this is a pulse triggered, master state. You can say that this is a master state, which is a pulse triggered. Yeah. Master state of T is flip-flop. So here, we have the JK flip-flop, right? Assume that this is a master slave JK. And if I short J and K, it becomes only one input. Yes. Now you can see, when T is equal to 0, that means both J and K will get 0, 0. And when both J and K are 0, 0, it is nothing but what? SR 0, 0. There won't be any change. Yes. When T is equal to 0, there won't be any change when I apply pulse, the clock cycle. Yes. And when I apply the clock cycle, and if T is equal to 1, I know that both J and K will get 1, 1. And what I mean by 1, 1? Output will be complement of previous, and that is what my previous is all about. Yes. Provided the clock cycle, if T is 0, output will follow the previous. If T is equal to 1, provided the clock cycle, my output will be complement of previous. Okay. So, JK 1, 1 for consecutive clock cycles, or T1 for the consecutive clock cycles, both are one and the same. Here, the same toggling effect, I'll get it. Okay. And the moment I won't apply my clock cycle, whether T is 0 or it is 1, my output will be previous. Okay. When I disable this particular flip-flop, by not applying the clock cycle means my output will be just following the previous. This is what about the master slave T flip-flop. Okay. This is, so till now we saw the latch, which is the level sensitive, and we could see the problem in the latch, that is whenever the clock was 1, my output was changing with respect to input. So we could overcome that in the master slave, and master slave is a pulse triggered. Now the third class of flip-flop we are coming into, that is the edge triggered. Okay. And in that we'll consider what is this positive edge triggered. Yes, positive edge triggered means edge is basically a transition from high to low or low to high. Okay. So this edge triggered, whatever your word you are saying, okay. So this edge triggered may be either this low to high transition or high to low transition, whatever the arrow I am specifying, that is what. Yes, this is 0 means this is 1, this is 1 means this is 0. Edge means this is what? This is a rising edge, high to low, sorry, low to high. This is a falling edge, high to low. Okay, a rising edge, that is, we call it as a transition from low to high as a rising or the positive edge. So this is my positive edge. This only this one, the transition I am seeing. This is the positive edge and this is my negative edge. Is that clear now? This is positive edge. This is negative edge. Okay, rising edge is a positive, falling edge is a negative for me. This is my negative edge. Okay, negative edge. Is that clear? This is what is my edge. Now we will see this particular flip-flop, how exactly it works now. Okay, and then we'll try to come and tell whether it is a positive edge triggered or something else. Okay, this is what we'll try to do now. Now again, we know that the importance of this clock. Initially, I let my clock or C to be 0. What is the meaning? This entire circuit is disabled. Okay. Now we'll see what really happens now. What is the first thing we have done? We have just made sure my clock or C is equal to 0. So one of the input of the NAND gate 2 is getting 0, and one of the input of the NAND gate 3 is getting 0 for me, right? This is what. And I least worry what is the other input for NAND gate 2 and what are the other inputs for NAND gate 3. And now Since I know one of the input of a NAND gate is 0, that is enough for me. I can simply say the output of the NAND gate 2 is 1 as well as the output of the NAND gate 3 is 1. That is the beauty of NAND gate, right? What is the, how you analyze or define a NAND gate? If one of the input of a NAND gate is 0 means, irrespective of other inputs, I can simply say output is 1 and that is what. And now what is this now? This is simple S bar R bar latch, or it is a SR latch using NAND gate, right? Yes, S bar is 1, R bar 1, meaning S0, R0 means what? This will be no change. So this will have its previous only. So this will be, if I just take this is my QT, this is QT bar, okay? This will be Q and this will be QT, okay? Q bar. If QT is the next present state, this will be my previous, that's what. And I least worry what is my Q and Q bar here, that's it. Okay, so now we started with the analysis by letting clock to be 0. One of the input of NAND gate 2 and one of the input of NAND gate 3 is 0, 0. So that's why the output of NAND gate 2 as well as the output of NAND gate 3 both are 1, 1. Yes, and since this is a S bar R bar latch, we know that for an S bar R bar latch, when both the input S bar and R bar 1, 1, output will be previous. Okay, so S bar R bar 1, 1 means S and R are nothing but what? 0, 0. And for an SR latch, when both S and R are 0, 0, output will be previous and that is what. Is this clear? Now what I'll try to do is, now I'll try to, being clock 0 still, I let or I assume D to be 0. And when D is 0 and R bar is 1, one of the input of the NAND gate 4 is 0 means I can simply say this is 1 now. Yes, output of NAND gate 4 is 1. And the same thing will go as one of the input for the NAND gate 3. And the same is fed as in one of the input of NAND gate 1 here. Yes, output of NAND gate 4 is acting as one of the input of NAND gate 3 as well as acting as a one of the input of NAND gate 1. Yes. And S bar is 1, that is output of NAND gate 2 is acting as a input of NAND gate 1. 1 and 1, output is 0. And this is fed as a one of the input for NAND gate 2. You can see that 0, 0 still 1. Okay. And this one is fed as an over here. So 1, 0, 1 still it is 1. Okay. So that's why. 1, 1. So S bar R bar doesn't change its value 1, 1. Even though I let D to be 0, provided clock is 0, and this will be its previous only. Okay. Now is very important now. Okay. So now clock was 0. Okay. Now clock from 0, I will just ensure it is going or it is having a transition from low to high, that is positive edge. Okay, that means this clock is going from, it was low, suddenly it is having a transition that is positive edge or rising edge. Okay, meaning what? This is becoming 1, that is the meaning. Now instead clock 0, now it is just becoming 1, rising edge. So here this is 1 now, and also this is 1. I am not changing D. D is still 0. My output of NAND gate 4 is still 1, and one of the input of NAND gate 3 is still 1, and the same thing holds good over here also. Yes, only change has happened is one of the input of NAND gate 2, which was 0, now it is becoming 1. One of the input for NAND gate 3 was 1, 0, it is becoming 1 because clock has just changed from 0 to 1, the transition. It has just, that rising edge has happened. Okay, from 0 it has become just 1. Just 1. Okay, now you can see that the NAND gate 3, if I try to analyze, 1, 1, 1. All the inputs of a NAND gate are 1 means output will be 0. So S bar is going to be 0. and there is a change in the one of the input of the NAND gate 4, that is 0. So previously R bar was 1, so that why it was 1. Now R bar is changing to 0, that's why it is 0. So now even though one of the input of the NAND gate 4 has changed 0, 0, 0, still this is 1. There is no change happening. And the same one goes here and the same one goes here. Yes. Now this was 0 previously, this is 0. One of the input of an AND gate is still 0, that's why this is 1. And if I take this 1 over here, it is 1. So S is still retaining the same 1. Only change happened was clock from 0, it has become 1. This 1, 1, R bar has become 0 and S bar is 1. So S bar 1, R bar 0 means what? S bar 1, R bar 0 means S 0, R 1. Meaning this is now, previously it was whatever, now Q is 0 whereas Q bar is 1. So now you can see that whenever there is a positive edge of the clock happening, okay, input was my D 0 and output is also 0. You can see that for the positive edge of the clock, D was 0, so my output is also 0. Is this clear now? Yes, that's what. Now, what I'll try to do is, now I retain this clock for some time, right? So my clock will be I for some time. Yes, this is what I mean by the clock is I for some time. Yes. Now you see, I change, clock is still 1 now. I'm not changing the clock. Clock is still 1, but it is not edge, but it is level now. I'm changing my D value to 1. One of the input for this NAND is 1 and other input is 0 means still this is 1. There is no change happening with respect to the output of NAND gate 4. This one still going. This is still 1. This is 1. So this is not changing. This is 1 here. This is 1. This is not changing. Even though D is changing, when clock is equal to 1, D changing, there is no change happening anywhere. Yes. What is happening to my output? It is just following the previous. Meaning, only this particular circuit diagram or the logic diagram, okay, is triggered or enabled only at the positive edge of the clock. And when the positive, at the positive edge of the clock, D was 0, so that's why output is 0. And for the remaining clock is equal to 1, even though I am changing my D value 1, 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, my output is not changing. What does this mean? This means that this particular D flip-flop circuit is an edge triggered and that too positive edge triggered, but this is not a level sensitive or a pulse triggered. Is this clear now? This is what. So one more example we will take considering something else. Okay. Same analysis we will do, but now the D will be changed. Okay. Again we start clock is equal to 0. That is one of the input for NAND gate 2 and NAND gate 3 will be 0. So that's why S bar 1, R bar 1. Yes. And this is again SR latch using NAND. That means it is S bar R bar latch. SR latch using NAND or S bar R bar latch. When both are 1, 1, if I assume this is my present state, okay, it will follow the previous, that is no change. Yes. Now I let D is equal to 1. Yes. This is 1 and you can see R bar is also 1. NANDing of 1 and 1 is nothing but what? 0. This is 0 and this is 0. And this S bar is 1. This is 0. And same thing, this is 0, 0, 1. This is 1, 1, 0, 0, this is 1. One of the input of a NAND gate 3 is 0 means output is 1. One of the input of NAND gate is 0 means output is 1. Yes. So, still clock is 0. And let putting D is equal to 1. Again, there is no change in S bar, R bar. It is retaining the same previous. Now see, my clock C, which was 0, now it is suddenly having a transition from low to high. That is a just becoming one. From low, it has just become, this edge. That means it is having a transition from 0 to 1. It has just become 1. That means one of the input of NAND gate 3 and one of the input of NAND gate are getting 1, 1. The rest all are remaining same, right? So, so it has just become, sorry, this has to be 1, sorry. This has to be 1. Because one of the input of NAND gate 1 means, 0 means it is 1, sorry. This has to be changed. So this was supposed to be 1. Okay. Previously, this was 0, that's what. Now, 1 NAND 1 means this is becoming 0. Anyhow, D is still 1. This is 1, 1 NAND 1, 0. One of the input of NAND gate 3, 1 means this is still 0 means it is still 1. Okay. And only change happening is with respect to S bar is becoming 0. So S bar, R bar 0, 1 means S and R is nothing but what? 1, 0. When S is 0, S is 1, R is 0 means output will be set. And output bar will be reset. You can see that the moment the C is going from low to high, when D is equal to 1, output is also 1. Okay, so you can see that when the positive edge of the clock appears, if D 1, the same thing will be at Q bar. Now, I retain this clock to be 1. That means I am not changing. Clock is still 1, but I am changing D from 1 to 0. 1 to 0. Yes. Now, this is 1. 1, 0. This is 1. This is 1. Yes. 1, 1. We'll see. This is 1. This is 0 basically. 1, 0. This is still 1. 1 and 1. This is still 0. 1, 1, 1. This is still 0. When 0, 0, what is happening? There is no change. No change means what? The same thing will apply. So you can see that only in the positive edge, Q is changing with respect to D. But when my C is now retaining, that is in this, this is what level. If it retains 1 for some time, even though there is a change in D, my output is not changing. That's why it is not a level sensitive, it is only a edge sensitive. So this is an example of a positive edge triggered D flip-flop. So meaning this particular flip-flop will be triggered only at the edge, that to positive edge. So you can see these are the symbols now, right? So only at C is having a transition, that is edge, if D 1, my Q will be 1. And for rest, until the next clock pulse, whatever D changes, there won't be any change. And if you see for the next clock pulse, if D is 0, my output is also 0. So this is the third class of flip-flop, that is an edge trigger, that to positive edge. Okay. So these are the different things that we have learnt in the lecture 1, 2, 3 and 4 about flip-flop. What is the basic, what is the meaning of flip-flop? Okay. It is basically a memory element, it which stores 1 bit. Okay. So then we saw different classes of flip-flop, that is latch, pulse triggered and the edge triggered. Okay. And with respect to the latches, it was a level sensitive. And then in the level sensitive, that too, when we go for the gated JK flip-flop, we could see there is a race around condition. That means output was not stable, even though input was stable. Okay. So then, we, in order to overcome that, we went to the master slave from level sensitive to pulse triggered. Okay. And then we saw the third class of flip-flop, that is an edge trigger. So from now onwards, either you can use a master slave or the edge triggered, both will overcome this race around conditions in the JK flip-flop. Okay, that's it. So we have completed the classes, then we'll see the applications. Okay, and all in the next thing. Okay, this is the same timing diagram with respect to the setup and hold time that we have discussed. Okay, so what is the setup time? Yes, my input should be, so this is the minimum time for which input held before my output latches. And what is the hold time? My input should be held after the output latches. Okay, the same thing we are seeing in terms of the positive edge trigger also. Okay, but since it is a triggering, since it is a positive edge, we have to ensure that this is what? That means before the clock appears, my input should be valid for some time. Okay, my input should be valid for some time, and this some time is nothing but what? This is what they have shown. If it is a edge triggered, and input should be valid after the application of the clock, and that is what I mean by, this is what I mean by, this gap. This is my setup time, hold time, and this is my setup time. Okay, so before the clock appears, input should be valid. After the clock appears, input should be valid, whether input is 1 or 0. Here also, before my clock appears, input is already appearing before clock, and input should be held after the clock also. Then only my output will be latched. Okay, whatever the D1 is there, that will be latched here. That means output will change with respect to input. And this timing, we call it as a propagation delay, right? This is my TP. Along with the setup and hold time, even we are having the propagation delay, that is TP. Propagation delay is what? The minimum time the input will make sure the output will change. And setup and hold time in the positive edge trigger, before the clock appears, my D input should be valid before. Or D input should appear before the clock comes, and also it should be valid after the application of the clock also. And if it is valid after the application of the clock, we will say it is a hold time. And if it is appearing before the clock time, minimum time, the minimum time before the clock appears, my D input is valid is the setup time. And minimum time after the application of the clock for which the D input is valid is nothing but what? The hold time. This is for the positive end. Then only I can see output vary with respect to the input. For example, now, this is my D. Okay, and this is my D input, this is my clock, and we'll try to see what is my Q. Something like this. You can see that D is having, clock is having a transition from low to high at the same time when D is changing from 0 to 1. Yes. Meaning, before clock appears, my D should have been 1, but it is not there, right? So that's why, even though if D is 1, my output is not changing with respect to this. My output never becomes 1 there. Why? Because I am violating the setup time. Hold time is there. After the application of the clock, my D input is still valid. But still output is not there. Why? Because I have to satisfy both setup and hold time. So this is what exactly we mean by the setup and hold time. Okay. So next, we'll see these two things, asynchronous inputs. What I mean by asynchronous inputs are, your J, K are in synchronous with the clock input that you apply. Okay, they are synchronous with the clock. Whenever there is a change in clock, we will see J, K, and we'll see what is the output happening. Okay, apart from this, suppose if I take, if this is my J, K, okay, this is my J, this is my K, this is my Q, and this is my Q bar, okay, and this is my clock input. My output changes in synchronous with clock along with J and K. Yes, when this particular flip-flop is enabled based on my clock, my output vary with respect to JK. That means JK are now in sync with C. But apart from these three inputs, clock, J and K, we will have something called PR and clear, preset and clear. So this is preset input, and this is my clear input. these preset and clear, they are not in sync with J, clock and K. Meaning here is, if I let preset to be one and make sure that preset and clear are exclusive to each other, meaning when preset is one, clear has to be zero, or when preset is zero, clear has to be one. Now what I have done, I have let preset to be one and clear to be zero. This means that it will set output or my flip-flop to one. Is this clear now? When I enable the preset, that means when I make preset to 1 and clear 0 means my flip-flop will be set to 1 irrespective of this. I can give any clock, I can give any JK, that won't change my queue. That is why these are asynchronous inputs. They are not in synchronous with JK clock. This is one. Or if I let preset to be 0 and if I enable clear means my flip-flop will be cleared. And if I retain my preset 0 and clear 1 for an entire, forever, my output will be always 0. Or if I let preset to be 1 and clear to be 0, forever, my output will be always set. Okay? These are the asynchronous input. So why we want preset and clear means, it is useful to bring a flip-flop to a desired initial state. See, sometimes we assume Q is to be 1 and Q is to be 0, 0. How you do? By letting the preset to be 0 and clear to be 1. Okay. So preset and clear are useful to bring a flip-flop to a desired initial state. So now, how to do that? Suppose I want my Q to be set initially and Q bar to be reset. Flip-flop to be set, right? I want initially flip-flop to be set. So what I'll do, I will let PR to be 1 and I will let clear to be 0. Irrespective of my J, irrespective of my K, and irrespective of my clock. Yes. J can be anything, K can be anything, clock can be anything. Irrespective of JK clock, if preset is 1 and clear is 0, I am just setting my flip-flop to a desired initial state, that is 1. Yes. Then, in order to enable this flip-flop as a JK, next, I disable both. Any of the clear it is disabled, I disable both. Preset is 0, clear is 0. Means what? These asynchronous inputs are not valid now because I have let both PR and clear to be 0, 0. When both PR and clear 0, 0, then my output Q, in this case, this Q, depends upon clock J and K. Okay? Then I can ensure, based on my clock, if I give J and K, my Q will vary. Oh, is that clear now? So in order to may ensure this JK flip-flop will work as a JK flip-flop provided PR and clear to be 0. Yes. In order to initially set for a desired output, then I will make use of preset and clear. That's it. That is the usefulness of asynchronous input. So you can see any master slave or JK, master slave JK or edge triggered flip-flops, you will see along with JKC inputs preset and clear. They are just useful to bring a flip-flop to a desired initial state. Once you get into the desired initial state, then you disable both. Okay, that's what. So that's what. This is the example they have given with respect to the preset and clear. Okay, one extra input preset. This is the asynchronous inputs. Preset and clear bar, they are the asynchronous inputs. Yes. Okay. So based on this, if preset is bar is 0 and clear bar is 0 means what? This is 1. This is 1. This is 1. clear bar as well. So this is 0, right? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Yes? One of the input NAND gate is 0 means this is 1. One of the input this NAND gate 2 is 1, this is 1. One of the input of NAND gate this is only 1, this is not there. This is 0 means this is 1. This is 0, this is preset. Okay, so anyway, we'll try to see this in the next session. Okay.